Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. Rad here from Radko Tarot, and this is going to be Leo Sun, Leo Moon and Leo Rising monthly tarot reading for January 2019. So that being said, while I'm shuffling the cards, I want to remind you once again, guys, that this is a general reading for Leo star sign, and therefore it will resonate in a different level with every single one of you. And for that purpose, or for that reason, in this video I will do my best to explain you the meanings of the cards and their synergy in the spread, but at the end it will be up to you to make sense of them and to align them to your personal situation, as every single Leo will have different situations. So if you want a specific cards draw for your personal situations and your personal situation to be analyze just like I'm doing with the examples in this video, well, that is a subject of a personal reading, and for personal readings you can check out my website listed down below in the description of this video, and there you are going to find a full list of my services as well as their pricing. And don't forget, if you go for that option, don't forget that by the till the end of the month of December, the prices for the 20 and the 30 minutes live reading with me are with reduced costs. So these are the five general cards for your spread here. We do have the Seven of Wands, which is in the general position. That will be the topic of your month, followed by the Lovers card, which is the intentional card or best possible course of action. Then what we do have is the Seven of Pentacles. These are the predicaments, that are challenges which are causing predicaments, followed by the Ten of Pentacles, which is the guidance the tarot is giving to you. And the last one, this is going to be the Ace of Swords, which is the final outcome. So this is going to be, for what it seems, one of the last month for struggle. And usually the struggle defined by the Seven of Wands, it does involve other people or other individuals, should I say that way. Very often different ideas which want to establish superiority, if I may express myself that way, or which wants to be proven superior to your personal ideas. So it's kind of like a competition, but in the same time the people that are involved are very peripheral. They are not directly influencing, but they are influencing from the exterior into your situations. Now this, as I said, this is going to be an enhanced tarot reading, so we are going to draw additional cards, and we do have the Sun card here into the Seven of Swords. So that is a confirmation that this is the last attempt of those people to truly influence your performance and influence your direction. I do think that this is about influencing a direction more than a competition meant to bring you down. Now what I mean with this is that let's say that you are working on an important project in career wise and that project can benefit many people, not just you but many people, and everybody is trying to influence you so that project can take such a direction to benefit mostly the person that is influencing you, while you are realizing that, you know, and probably you will start doing anything you can in order to push on this undertaking, or in that specific example, that project, to benefit everybody with, let's say, a balanced outcome. So it's not going to be completely in favor of one or another, but it's going to be dragged to the toward the common good, so everybody can actually see benefits from it. That is displayed here with the Sun card, which points that if you maintain your humbled and balanced position, all right, this competition here that you do have will not have much of a chance, but rather will be sitting from a side, let's say, and even though making attempts to swirl you this way and that way, either relationship wise or career wise, they will see that, or they will also start feeling that through influencing or rather jeopardizing, you know, your performance. They are also jeopardizing their personal benefits from whatever you're trying to push. I hope that that kind of makes sense. I will give you one more example. Let's say that you are in a relationship, a pretty good one, but the one of the parents of your partner, either a woman or a man, doesn't like the state of the relationship, all right, for one or another reason, and they're trying to influence that relationship in such a way that they actually meet their personal means. For example, they want to see you married, but you and your boyfriend are not married yet, so they are influencing that relationship in such a way to make you marry for that person or to make that person marry for you. And the more they're influencing it, the more they see that they're jeopardizing the relationship itself. So therefore, they will see that, you know, that will prove futile influencing it, and therefore they will stop doing it. So again, it is the final month where you're going to see resistance from others and from a situation, because the more resistance people and situations are giving you, the less benefits they are going to draw out from it. And this is going to be the month where they are going to realize that, and they will stop giving you a hard time. And from there, we do have the Lover's card, which is the best possible course of action, or the how can I place it, the intentions, with the Ten of Swords here. So this is a very potent and very powerful combination. What the combination points is that here you should completely disregard how others see and feel you in general, but you should completely focus only on those activities, enterprises, and people in your life which are making your life run harmoniously, all right? So if we follow that example with the relationship here, you know, the parents of your girlfriend or a boyfriend, or your parents for that matter, are not going to make the relationship running harmoniously if they're pushing into their selfish personal direction. So that's why you have to completely disregard either of their opinion here, even if that is going to be rather difficult. And it will be difficult here with the Ten of Swords, because it will require a very drastic measures, kind of like what I like to say here is irrevocable decisions or irreversible actions, and etc. etc. But basically, what these cards here are pointing is that you have to finally, you know, do what it is needed, even if it is not a milder approach toward the situation, in order to establish a harmony and, in general, peaceful environment for the life that you are aiming to have. Because the Lover's card here, as intentional wise, is giving us, and or is giving you, Leo, the confirmation that should you have the determined decision to establish harmony, either in relationship or either in career, you can do that, but it's not going to happen by you trying to please everybody along with yourself. First thing that you need to do here is think about the common good, or rather like the natural way how your project or your relationship should unfold. And everybody who jeopardizes the natural way should be completely disregarded and should not receive any attention whatsoever, either with their proposition or either with their attempt to influence war on or another undertaking. Additionally, these cards, just on a very superficial level as meanings, it may mean jumping into a premature relationship. Just saying here, with the Ten of Swords appearing, appearance with the Sun card here in a secondary position, it may mean that one is already, you know, had enough from being singular or for being single throughout the previous half a year or 1 year, and here in the months of January, an opportunity for them to jump into a relationship kind of present itself, and one makes the drastic decision and the drastic measures to jump into it, although one realizes that is not, at least at the start, is not going to be an ultimate happiness, but yet it has a prerequisites to become one. The next card that we do have are the challenges which are causing predicaments. That is going to be the Seven of Pentacles with the Ten of Cups. So what we do have here, it is the I don't like to use that word, but more like the insight or the realization of one's personal blessings. What these cards here are pointing is that either you, Leo, are not using your blessings, or you're not appreciating your blessings that you currently possess to their full maximum. What the Seven of Pentacles is in tarot, it's about, you know, scaling down how much you invest against how much you gain from it. And the Ten of Cups here only strengthens this card, pointing that you are investing way too much personal blessings and personal resources, like time, like efforts, you know, or like happiness as well, emotional investments into activities pointed here that actually are giving you way too little. So in other words, these cards here are pointing that you should stop following foreign code of conducts if they don't make you feel happy, and generally if you don't see that there is something in it, but you are rather following those code of conducts just so you can make someone else is happy. The happiness for every single one that is around you is gonna come from your achievement here, but your achievement should not be focused upon one single person than yourself. So in other words, what this reading says here is that people who are not happy when you reach a point of happiness, then they don't belong around you. And what I like to say in these situations, guys, is that let's say you are in a relationship. If your happiness is not your partner's happiness, then obviously you are not meant to be together, all right? So when you are happy, when something you do makes you happy, instantly should make your partner happy as well. And this is something that you should realize throughout that month, or seek people and situations which are aligning themselves in such way according to you. So if you are single, this card here are pointing that even though you have many handsome guys or girls around you that you can be in a relationship with, you should seek this one which it is happy when you are happy, all right? And that will be a tough thing to be done, but in the same time not impossible. Again, that is a challenge here that causes predicaments, but as a challenge can and should be overcome as well. But it is very important with these cards, when we do have, not to give away way too much, at least at the start of the initiate state of one's project or of one's relationship as well, but rather take it easy, invest little by little until you don't see that the other person or the situation itself does not repay back according to your investments. The next card that we do have, this is the guidance card, and that will be the Ten of Pentacles here with the Page of Swords. So we do have a person, and these cards are pointing that you should not surround yourself. That is a general criteria for a person, not a specific one, as we do have the Ten of Pentacles. So these cards are pointing that you should not kind of connect yourself. I don't know the exact English word, but let's say involve yourself with people that does not share your system of beliefs and does not share your opinion. Again, what we said here is that you are going to have people with different ideas and different opinions, and those, and by associating yourself with these people, are going to jeopardize your state of harmony and as well the indulgement of one achievement throughout the month. Therefore, you should completely seek deliberating yourself from those people and cut ties and strings with them. Additionally, that could be as well someone that you did not kind of had it recently next to you. It could be someone from your past, let's say an ex-friend or an ex-girlfriend for that matter, or it could be an ex-boyfriend as well, which miraculously appear for the month of January, and they're trying to come around you. They're trying to establish positions once again into your social circle or in your life for that matter. But in the same time, the more you allow them in, the more you are going to realize that they haven't changed a bit, and they're once again kind of like possessing your environment, and they are shaping it according to your to their system of beliefs rather than to your system of beliefs. And you should completely build a strong and solid wall with such kind of a people. So your general rule here should be that if someone does not share your positions, has no place around you. All right, because they cannot give you just as much as you are investing in these kind of relationships or project, or they cannot give you the things at least that are going to make you happy in such kind of relationships or such kind of investments into projects as well. And at the end, we do have the Ace of Swords here with the Knight of Pentacles. So these cards are pointing that you are at the end of the month, you will see the right path for you. That is more, that is for sure here with the Ace of Swords. What concerns me is the Knight of Pentacles falling into a secondary card. And what this card points in this specific follow-up, it says that you will realize that it is a bit harder than you thought it is. And I believe that it has a connection here with the Ace, with the Ten of Swords and the Lovers card. And that will be consolidating upon the mantra that you cannot please everybody. And if you try to please someone else is going to be displeased. So you have to choose your allies very carefully, and for that matter, they have to be chosen according to what you have as an ideas and what you have as a system of beliefs. Once again, you know, if someone else's happiness is not connected to your happiness, or in another word, if someone is not happy when you are happy, just from the undertakings you are contributing in themselves, then these people does not have place around you. So I think that this month is going to be a month of big wake-up call here, discerning who is going to be helpful for your further development, and who is going to slow you down, either with their standpoints or either with their moody behavior, should I say that way, and in the same time with their performance as well, with their undertaking. Again, someone could jeopardize your relationship or your projects at work just because they are acting surreptitiously and they want to strain your relationship or your project toward their own personal benefit rather than toward yours. Why? Because they are not feeling happy when you're feeling happy. So you have to build a wall in between you and such kind of people. So generally, the message here is that you should cut ties with negative people in your life, and negative person is relatively kind of like a profound meaning. You know, one person could be negative for you and positive for someone else, so you have to find your own positive people. And the last card here, it is pointing that things are not as simple as they seem. All right, it takes a lot of conversations, it takes a lot of deliberations, it takes a lot of analysis as well upon one person. But should you be objective about them, should you be objective about your friends and about your about the projects and about the co-workers and etc, completely disregarding your emotions as well, because you may know that someone is not beneficial for your projects, let's say into your career, but just because you're feeling bad for them, you're commiserating to them, that may make you involve them in your project even if the pure logic tells you that they will just only slow you down. So it's very important here to make the accurate analysis upon who in your life is going to help you and who is valuing your happiness based on the things that you are doing and who isn't. So literally, this was your reading for January 2019, Cancer, Leo, oh my God. So yeah, and Once again, that was a general reading for Leo star sign for January 2019. I hope you enjoyed it and you liked it, and once again, this reading is going to resonate in a different level with every single one of you, because you do have different situations, you different Leos. And if you do want a personal reading with me, you can check out my website that is listed down below in the description of this video, and there you can find a full list of my services as well as their pricing. Rad signing out now. See you next time. Bye.